Hey everybody, this is Nick Baldwin, and today I'm being joined by the former Bellator women's featherweight champion, Julia Budd, who will be making her PFL debut coming up next week on October 27th against Kaitlyn Young. Julia, how are you?
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. Appreciate you taking the time. And first of all, I want to talk about your stepson, Lance Gibson Jr. just picked up another big win over the weekend at Bellator 268. What did you think about his performance?
Oh, I'm so proud of him. It was amazing, obviously. He shows a level that his record doesn't really show. Like he's got so much maturity in there, and he's grown up in martial arts. So seeing him perform the way that he does in there is just we're all so proud of him. So
yeah. And you must mean record, you know, in terms of his how many fights he's had, because he's undefeated. Yeah. He's never lost.
Exactly. But just being like a 4-0 fighter before this, and now seeing that and just seeing that relaxed in the first round and hurting the guy off his back, and then coming back in the second round and knocking him out was just like, he just stayed super calm, cool, and collected and got the job done, and we couldn't be more proud. So
how is it going from corner person coach 1 week to, you know, you're getting ready for your fight in 8 days now? Like there's not a lot of time in between. It's a quick turnaround. Is it easy to go from one role to being a fighter?
Yeah, a lot easier than my last fight, which was like, I think we had like an hour between my fight and his fight.
That's true. Yeah.
it's a lot better this way. And you know, and during fight week, I just kept up on all my training and my grind, didn't stop. I got my goal in mind the whole time. So, my goal for his fight week is to be the best corner woman I could possibly be and be his support person, but also, my eyes on the prize at all times. So not forgetting, the job that I have to do next week.
Is there anything you do to help make sure you're staying focused on both things, like, and not, you know, just focus on Lance Jr.'s fight and forget about your fight or vice versa? Like, is there anything you can do to just help with that?
You know what? I think it's just about being present in the present moment. So every day accomplishing what I need to accomplish, making sure I get my work in, but at the same time, being able to be present and be there for him for his fight week and as a training partner and everything as well. So I'm used to multitasking, but it's just now it's like, we're all so excited and we're riding that high of his win. And now it's my turn. So look forward to it.
And I got to ask, what was it like being back at your first Bellator fight week as a non-Bellator fighter?
I mean, it's it felt like, you know, they're like family. So it felt the same as before, but now it's his turn to kind of carry on in Bellator. And so it just felt good. It felt normal.
So I want to ask about the latest with your career. Obviously, you signed with PFL not too long ago. You're making your debut next week, as I said off the top. Why did you ultimately decide to part ways with Bellator after fighting out your contract there and sign with this new promotion, PFL?
Well, I think it was a couple of things. I was ready for a change. The stage of my career being knowing the clear trajectory to the championship bouts, that offer for to be part of the 2022 season, but also having the showcase fight, you know, right around the corner when we were talking to them for October 27th was just like another huge bonus on top of next year's plan. So I'm a goal-oriented individual, and having that schedule and that layout of like, okay, this is what you got to do to get to the title fight. I know how to do that. And it's just exciting to know that I can bank on those fights next year and when they're happening and prepare accordingly.
So when you fought your last Bellator fight in April, did you have a feeling, you know, as soon as that fight wrapped up, this probably was your last one in Bellator? At that point, did you have no idea what was going to happen?
No, we asked to be released. That was my last fight on my contract. We asked to be released and be an alternate. We were actually offered to be an alternate in the 2021 season. So I wouldn't say right after, but you know, after my last fight, going back to the drawing board and just saying like, you know, what would appeal to me staying with Bellator would be that rematch with Cris. Is that going to happen? I don't know. She doesn't want the rematches with people that she's already beat. So that's kind of like what the hemming and hawing on her that end was. But then we had this opportunity to fill in as an alternate for this year's season. And that was super exciting. So we asked to be released early, and that never kind of came to fruition. So we never, the talking back and forth kind of finalized in the end of September, when I could finally announce that I've signed with PFL and announced that I was fighting October 27th. But what I can say is I was getting ready for a long time before that.
And so just to clarify, when you say you were you asked Bellator for your release, was it more so just, you know, them to waive like the I don't know what you call it, like the rights they have to basically negotiate with you as a free agent? That's what you're talking about?
Yeah, so we weren't allowed to talk to, so it's a 90-day kind of like period clause, of time where you can just talk to them, and there wasn't really any communication there. Like there wasn't like a back and forth during that time. So the 90-day period was, we asked to see, okay, could we, you know, potentially talk to PFL and get in on this opportunity. That didn't work out. And I'm a big believer that everything, you know, it happens for a reason. So I think it's meant to be this way. And I'm at peace with that. And I just stayed focused and kept training and kept getting ready and stayed focused on this what's happening. So it all worked out in the end. And there's no hard feelings. And it is what it is. I had an amazing 7 years with Bellator. I was able to become a world champion and defend my belt multiple times. Those were all like awesome things as for me, when I look back on my legacy and my career, I can be proud of those and be proud of this period of time that I helped build the 145 division and make it into what it is today. So I was a key part in that piece of that puzzle. And I just feel like that's something that I'm definitely proud of. And I'm grateful for my time there.
And I just wanted to sort of clarify and ask about one other thing you said with the potential Cris Cyborg rematch. Is that something you were interested in and potentially would have stayed on board with Bellator if that could have happened?
Yeah. If there was like a clear, like the thing is it was, it's what one of the big reasons talking to PFL was so exciting was it was like, here you got to go this is what we're offering, and this is your way to a championship fight, and it was just like, oh, that makes a lot of sense, and that was appealing to me. That wasn't kind of like, it wasn't like that was the clear, there was not a lot of clarity of like, okay, your next fight is the title contender fight, or your next fight you'll get the rematch or whatever. And I should have got the rematch right away, immediately after that fight. It was a close fight. I was the champ for so many years before. So I felt like that should have been the next fight for me. But it is what it is. Everything happens for a reason.
And when you said, as far as one of the reasons you wanted to move on and sign with PFL is you just felt you were ready for something different, ready for a change. How do you know, or how did you know you were ready for a change? What was that sort of feeling like? And how are you able to just know that it was time for you to get something, you know, do something else?
I think it just that fire, like that fire inside that makes me hungry to train and get after it, and knowing those clear goals that I have to conquer. And that was kind of the like, okay, as soon as I heard this potential of this fight, but also potentially being an alternate, and then the 2022 season, it was like this wave came over me, and I got really hungry to get in there and you know, get after it. So yeah. I think that was kind of a key factor was like that part.
PFL is obviously a lot different than any other MMA promotion like UFC or Bellator, with the tournament format, with, you know, everyone knows who they're fighting next, million dollar grand prize at the end of it all. What do you find to be the most sort of interesting or intriguing part about PFL as a whole?
So I think that one of the things is like watching the tournament and watching the style. I think some of the guys that have come over, or some of the people that have come over from other organizations, underestimated the speed at which people are trying to get after it and finish it. And I think it makes everybody, it's kind of exciting because everybody knows what's on the line and people are going for it 100% and going after it. And you can kind of feel that in the, in watching PFL. It's like, it just makes it more exciting. There's more, it's like seeing who's going to make it to the championships and seeing fighters that you kind of didn't think were going to win come out and do have these amazing performances because they're just hungry for that opportunity. So I think that is one of it. Also that they're kind of trying to do it like a league format. So just that whole, the playoffs and then the championships and stuff, it's exciting. It's kind of different and I think it's cool.
And it makes it feel like one of the big four sports like baseball or hockey or something like that.
Yeah. It's awesome. And it's also been really cool to see what they've done with the 155 pound women's division and see what they've done with Kayla's career and what she's done and accomplished. And it's made it an appealing place for girls that can't make, 125, 115, 135 available. It's made it another home for us. So I think that's, I did that with me and Marlos were the first 145ers to do that for Bellator and make that a place for women to go. And I think this is a definitely appealing place for women now.
Yeah. And this will be your first fight in almost 8 years that didn't take place under the Bellator banner. So that just sort of speaks volumes about how long you were with one promotion. Do you think there'll be any sort of jitters like in this first PFL fight, even though you're very experienced, you're a veteran, like, is there going to be any sort of nerves or extra nerves given the new
promotion? Oh yeah. I think I'm really excited about this. So it's like, whenever you're doing something that you love and you're passionate about, I think that there's like some jitters because I care that I go out there and I have an amazing performance and I get my hands raised. So yeah, there'll be some jitters, but I'm looking forward to a new experience and whatever comes. So yeah, I'm ready.
And I feel like this is a nice way to sort of be introduced to PFL. You're not thrown into the tournament right away. Like you get one fight before that and I don't know. It's just an easier way into the new promotion, I guess. Hey.
Yeah. Well, I wouldn't say easier, but it's definitely a way that I can go and introduce myself to all my new bosses and everybody that I'm going to be working for. And also I'm fighting a tough girl that is a good opponent. I was excited when I mentioned that it would be Kaitlyn Young. I was like, oh yeah, this is an awesome fight for me. And getting to fight her, a quality opponent that on October 27th and going out and having an incredible experience is my goal. So,
yeah, I mean, the fight's not any easier just because it's not part of the tournament. That doesn't change.
No, but still, I know what you mean. It's kind of nice that I'm getting to get in there, have a fight this year. That was kind of critical to me signing as well, as I didn't want to sit out the rest of 2021. Healthy. I'm ready to go. So I basically was like, can we get in on this last fight card? And they made it happen. And I'm so looking forward to it. And then starting next year, knowing what's ahead for me next year is also exciting. So
were there any other options on the table? Was it kind of PFL and that's it? Or were you in talks with potentially other promotions?
I think that for where I'm at and what I want to do and how... I mean, it was obviously the rematch with Chris. If there's a potential title fight for whatever the UFC is doing with the 145 division or PFL, and PFL is to me the most exciting offer, and I'm just so excited to be a part of the team.
Yeah, is there anything specifically that drew you away from wanting to be in the UFC just because that's the place that everyone wants to be, or is it more so PFL was just a more intriguing promotion for where you're at?
I think that it was the offer, the way the offer came through and knowing the clear trajectory to the top was what made PFL such an easy decision for me. It was like, oh no, this is what I want to do. I've been watching the tournament, rewatching the 2019 tournament, seeing how it's laid out. And it's like, I want in on this.
Yeah. How long did you sign on for? Obviously this fight, and then I know for it's confirmed that you're going to be part of the next season. Is that where it ends for now?
Um, I'm a one day at a time kind of a person, one step at a time. So it's really important that I do my job. I have an amazing performance on October 27th. Then from there, 2022 season, one fight at a time. I think a lot of people do get caught up in that $1 million. They see this $1 million check or something, and at the start of the tournament, and it's like your job. You have to do your job every single fight, and it's a point system too. So it's just one fight at a time to the top, and then we'll obviously revisit it then.
Yeah. How do you feel about competing up at 155 for this fight?
It's exciting.
Or is this fight exciting?
No, this fight's at 155.
155, okay.
It's awesome because I can just focus on training. I don't need to worry about my diet too much. And obviously, like, I always eat healthy. My lifestyle is a healthy lifestyle. So I'm always eating healthy, but at the same time, I don't have to worry about cutting weight right now. I can just focus on training 100%. And that was really cool too, to have a back-to-back training camp with Lance Jr. because I could, again, like, I'm not worrying about my diet when I'm down there helping him. I can just be there as a training partner, coach, and getting ready for my fight. I'm not worrying about my diet the whole time. So it's been nice. And I look forward to the challenge of fighting bigger girls as well. So
do you expect in some ways to have a better performance than usual just because you don't have to cut that weight and you don't have to focus on cutting that weight?
Yeah, like I think so. I'm prepared to, yeah, I haven't even thought about it in that sense. I haven't even given it a lot of thought about my weight because it's even at 145, I never really thought about it that much. It was always right. It's always just like a part of the job, just making my weight and doing that and getting in there and having a, doing great. So, but yeah, now that I'm thinking about it, it's like, I can just focus fully on the task at hand. I don't need to be distracted by, every little thing that I'm eating. So
has PFL said to you at all about whether they plan to do 145 or 155 next year?
No, they haven't. They haven't mentioned it to me, but either way, I'm comfortable at either weight class.
Yeah. Okay. And then obviously sort of what everybody is talking about with you coming over to PFL is that potential Kayla Harrison fight. Is that, what was that at all sort of one of the reasons you wanted to be in PFL given that possibility? It would be a big fight for women's MMA. Is that something you were thinking about? You are thinking about at all?
Yeah, definitely. I want to fight the best of the best. And I respect her and her skills. And I think she's come a long way in mixed martial arts as well. So yeah, that fight would be definitely exciting for me. But again, it's like, you never know, like the tournament, this is my first time going into the tournament and not knowing who you draw. Like that fight could be any of the fights. And also playing out in our mind, like, oh, if anybody fell out on October 27th, that could potentially happen. But I'm like, no, and they've got an alternate already on board. So I'm just excited. Yeah, I'm excited to fight all the girls in that division. And she's been a great champion there. So I'm definitely excited to fight her.
And that's something I wanted to ask you about earlier when you mentioned it. What happened with your request to be the ultimate for this tournament? Obviously it didn't happen, but.
No, just couldn't. My contract wasn't up yet and okay. It didn't work out. So I kind of, yeah, everything kind of came to, everything was finalized end of September and it was just too late already. Like they've already had their alternate in there and the girls have already put the work in for the 2021 season. So there's enough of them that are already kind of would be the backup choice for if any of the fights fell through.
And obviously one of the big stories going into October 27th surrounding Kayla Harrison is the fact that this is or could be her last PFL belt. She'll be a free agent after this season wraps up. Do you have you given any thought as to what you think will actually happen with Kayla's career, as we enter 2022?
No, it's her journey. So whatever happens, like good for her. That's awesome, but I'm focused on me and I'm focused on what I got to do. So I think if people get too obsessed with fighting one person, then they overlook the people that are right in front of them. And I'm not one to do that. So I'm excited about fighting any of those girls. There's some dangerous girls in the 155 pound division, and I look forward to fighting whoever's there and bringing my absolute best. So that's what I'm doing.
Well, on that note, it's Kaitlyn Young, October 27th, PFL 10, your PFL debut, of course. How do you think this fight ends, and how do you think it plays out?
I think that it ends by me finishing her. I'm going for it. So I'm in my absolute best. I'm the best condition I've ever been, and best shape of my life. And I'm looking forward to going in there and getting the win and getting my hands raised.
All right, Julia, thanks so much for taking the time. I appreciate it. And best of luck to you next week.
Thank you.